but he hasn't molested anyone in years. TW, child molestation. First post here. Sorry for the formatting, I'm on mobile. Backstory, my older cousin molested me for 6 years and molested his brother and sister for 8 years. He was caught red-handed with his bro and sis when he was still a teenager and went through the courts and rehabilitation. This was years ago. Now he's married and has a son who's exactly a month older than my son. Cast EA, entitled aunt, molester's mom. M, the dreaded molester cousin. U, molester's wife. IB, the her son, the innocent baby. Me, magnificent example. BF, my boyfriend. S, my son. RCS, random cousin's son. So at the time my son is nearing his first birthday and I get a phone call from EA. At the time I was on speaking terms with her, not anymore, not because of this, the phone call starts out pretty okay. EA, hi me. How's mom life? Me, pretty good EA. Finally seem to be getting the hang of it. EA, S is almost 1 year old now. IB will be 1 month before S. And RCS a month after that. Me, wait, really? I didn't realize all three babies were that close together. Yay, yeah. We should get all three babies together for a photo shoot after their birthdays. I stopped cold. I promised myself I would never allow M around any of my children, and BF had already threatened to kill him if he came anywhere near me ever again. I was still trying to keep the peace a bit and was trying to think of a nice way to put it. Me, that would be nice, but we're pretty broke and I don't think I can make it to city 6 hours away anytime soon. Yay, well maybe we could come visit you. Me, that wouldn't be a good idea. Yay, BF and I live in a two-bedroom apartment with a roommate. Yay, we could camp out in the living room. Me, nobody here would be comfortable with that. Besides, M isn't allowed around S, so it would have to be just you and you. Yay, what do you mean M isn't allowed around S? We're family. Me, you, IB, and pretty much everyone else can come visit, provided you stay in a hotel room, but M will never be within 30 miles of my son. He lost that privilege when he decided to molest me and your other children. Yay, but he hasn't done any of that stuff in years. Can't we all just forget about that? It happened so long ago. Long ago was about 6 years at this point. And EA refuses to talk about what M did most of the time and refuses to use the words molested or raped when she does talk about it. She just says vague words like stuff and things. Me, EA, no. I'm not going to feel bad for not letting a convicted child molester around my son. He may be reformed or whatever, but that doesn't erase his past actions, and I'm not going to risk the safety of my child. EA, well what if we just show up at your door? Me, well then M better learn how to run fast, because BF knows about what he did to me and he already wants to kill him. The only reason he hasn't is because M lives in city 6 hours away. Yay, but we're family. Me, you are. He isn't. Yay, hangs up. I thought that was the end of that discussion. I had to calm down my very protective BF from driving to city 6 hours away and killing M just to keep him away from S. I told him that I put my foot down and I don't think anyone would bother me about it. Boy was I wrong. The next day I get a phone call from an unknown number. Me, hello. MW, hi, is this Garnet Stronger Danyo? Me, yes. Who's this? MW, it's MW. M's wife. I had met this woman once at a wedding when she was pregnant with IB. And she didn't say two words to me. Me, oh. Hi. What's up? MW, EA and I were talking about doing a cute photo shoot with IB, RCS, and S later this year. Since they're all so close in age, what do you think? Me, afraid to go through this again, well it's a good idea on paper, but there's no way. BF and I are broke and I don't want to travel with an infant. But even if we could coordinate to have it in my city, I wouldn't want to tear you away from your husband for too long. MW, well he could come with. Me, not if you want me or S there. MW, why are you doing this? Me, excuse me. MW, we're trying to do something nice for you and you're making it impossible. Besides, M is with me now. And we have a son. He's better now. At this point I was done being polite. May, look, your husband molested me for 6 years. He is a child molester and he will never be allowed around S, never. If you want to risk your child, that's your business. I hung up. Thankfully I didn't ever hear anything else on the subject again. I did hear a few rumors about griping from some family members. But most of my other cousins with kids understood and my parents supported me. Though I did feel a bit vindicated by my decision when M was caught sexting a 15-year-old about 9 months later. Edit 1, thank you so much for the support I have received. Also for the gold and silver. Holy shit. Edit 2, since apparently some people think this is BS. Here's my trauma timeline. M is 2 years older than me, I was 5 and he was 7 when it started. He stopped with me when I was 11. 6 years. I have no clue when he started molesting his siblings, but I know he was caught red-handed by EA the summer before I turned 13. Our sons are almost 4 at this point. Hopefully that clears up things for people who demand the math lines up. Edit 3, fix the EU/MW mix-up. Sorry. Edit 4, M is currently in jail for the incident with the 15-year-old. He's not divorced and his wife still brings their son to visit him. I don't know any more information. Sorry. He sexted a 15-year-old 9 months later? Guess old habits really do die hard. He got caught sexting a 15-year-old 9 months later. God only knows how long that was going on or what else he was up to. I was really hoping the EA and MW would turn around and apologize to UP after hearing about that, but I guess they probably think it was innocent. How the fuck does a child molester find a wife? And some of those wives pimp out their children to child molesters because they don't care. And also when the wives report that shit, but a couple months later they want to deny it and not press charges. That's why you need a bulldog prosecutor not willing to let that shit go once they've got a handle on it. It's like 4 out of 5 times I've seen a wife and mom come with her daughter out of anger and jealousy to charge the offender, and then weeks to months later she wants to drop the charges. I intervened in a domestic violence incident. I'm having a smoke outside my office and suddenly see this middle-aged guy assaulting a woman across the parking lot, grabbing, hair pulling, throwing her to the ground. He jumped in his car and took off when he saw me, a largish male, running up on him. Less than a half hour later, she swore to the cops he had never done anything like that before. Yeah, a middle-aged guy just snapped and started beating his girlfriend in the parking lot of the juvenile courthouse in broad daylight and full view of at least a dozen state child welfare and county juvenile justice bureau employees. And several people who were there for their own hearings recorded him leaving and offered it to the cops. I mostly feel sad for women like her. She's not getting out of the cycle anytime soon. If ever. My cousin is a SVU prosecutor and so I've been shadowing her because I'd like to be the same thing, and she's a fucking bulldog dude, but she says all the time that that's how it is. People don't care about their kids or themselves being sexually assaulted, they just want to stay in that relationship. And I can empathize, sort of, because I don't want to judge people for being in that abusive place, but also like, really. What about the well-being of your children? I don't know. It's too hard to watch. It really is difficult. You have to learn quickly how to put a mental layer between you and the clients. And always remember, once the court or child welfare gets involved, there probably aren't any good options, you're just choosing the least bad of the options left. It really is satisfying to see an actual perp held accountable. But I remember one case that was tragic. Young lady, quite pretty, who had a standing pickup order for when she had any more kids. She was so low performing intellectually, she could not make the connection between sex and babies. She also had no idea how to care for a baby. I checked in on a visitation room because I heard a baby screaming. Not just crying, she was holding it and looked at me like, what do I do? Trust me, supervised visitation can break your heart. Even when it goes well, the children often cry when the parents have to leave. But if you can deal with all that, more power to you. I honestly don't even know how he is allowed to be around any children, even his own. You did the right thing. Your job now is to protect your family, whether someone has been rehabilitated or not, obviously not in this case. EA needs to just shut her pie hole and get some serious therapy, as she seems to have not addressed the issue for what it is. There is some serious rug sweeping going on in that family. Probably because he was a minor at the time and EA made everyone downplay it. My theory anyway. Maybe because EA was also married to a molester and knew about it while her son, M, was abused, causing a cycle of abuse she isn't willing to admit is partially her fault. Damn, that makes the denial really believable. No. It was a neighbor when M and his siblings were small and their paternal grandfather. But there's a lot of rug sweeping. Mostly it's the family religion that calls for forgiving M and I'm looked down upon because I haven't. Abuse apologists and enablers are just as bad TBH. My nan is married to a pedophile who molested me and my cousins when I was fucking 3 years old and never stopped until I was old enough to refuse to visit them. Nan insists he's better, he did it because he's autistic, he's not, she decided this without medical consultation, also he's vegan now and that somehow is supposed to help. Yet the first words from her when she was told what he did was, "I was afraid something like this would happen." Big think. Autism equals pedophile according to you, Nan? Don't tell the anti-vaxxers. There was a guy who went to a youth club thing I go to. He had been banned multiple times, they kept giving him second chances, for touching people inappropriately and sexually assaulting one of the people there. He also creeped on my friend the first day he went there, my friend never came back and still refuses to, even though the guy doesn't come anymore. Blamed everything on his ADHD. ADHD makes it hard for you to focus things, like math class. It does not make you more inclined to be a sexual deviant.